Hi, this is Peter, cartoon pal, and you're listening Panther Pod on the Coral Springs Chatter Radio Network.
Yes, well, go Panthers. Yes, that's what you want, isn't it? Yes, go chase the stick, doggy, yes.
Good afternoon, everybody. How we doing? We're back with the Panther Pod. 2 weeks in a row. I think there's a new record. I don't think we have ever had two so close together. We have the Queen Tajalli. Welcome, Hannah. Hannah Tajalli is with us, making her Panther Pod debut. Additionally, we have Ice T. Am I allowed to call him that here, Colin?
I believe so. Are you okay with the Colin?
Oh, that's a different endorsement. We have Jacob Fentress. Jacob, we don't get to see him that much anymore. He's kind of like a phantom. What's going on, Jacob? It's good to see you. Yeah, you can't wait to get out of here, or you can't wait to graduate? And we have DJ Tarquinio making his return to the Panther Pod. How are you doing, dude? I'm fine. It's great to see all of you here. We are back for episode, I guess, technically number two. We got Collin Teschky back with us again. How are you, Collin?
Doing great. Been a solid week. Late work day today, so.
Yes, today is the late work date. I actually have some questions about that for you guys. So let's just dive right in. All right. Well, we said hello to everybody. And now, so there's a lot of things going on at school right now. One of which, there was a very exciting dance concert last week. Who, I don't really understand what the whole thing is. So luckily, we have Jacob here, who's going to talk to us about how the whole thing works. Because when I saw the people in this thing, I was surprised. So tell us about the dance concert.
Like, most of the dance concert wasn't like, if you had a dance costume, you'd take it. But I feel like it was more of like the momentum part of it.
Right.
So like there was like, they have like their own separate like actual like group. And like they stay after school practice every day for like, I think since like you said October. So after school, they would always like go to it. And like for us, we would just rehearse in class. But it's still cool because we each class got like two dances, so like we would have like a slow and like a hip hop dance.
Right.
So yeah.
So you're not part of Momentum.
No, I just
you're
like
in
dance.
The class.
Yeah. And there's like dance one and dance two, but it's my first year taking it because I thought I was gonna take it like with my friends.
Right.
But like they took it last year, so like I was in dance one and they were in dance two. So.
Did you enjoy it?
No, yeah, it was fun. It was a great experience. A lot of people came out. There was like three nights of it, so. And I kind of, like, underestimated it, I would say, because, like, it was actually made me tired. Like, I thought dancing was just dancing, but, like, I don't know. Like, you ever see, like, the movie Footloose?
Yeah, of course did I see
it reminded
the
me of Footloose,
Footloose,
so I was like, damn.
Well, dance, it's tiring.
Nah,
and you as an athlete should know that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you have a solo?
I had, like, a little parts where I had to, like, stand up, go, like, hold on, but, like, that was, like, really it.
Well, I saw it.
Yeah.
I mean, but I want to hear what you got, because you guys saw it, weren't you?
I mean, like,
some of you were there.
Yeah, y'all came, right?
DJ, tell us.
I was a little busy.
Well, DJ, did you? Can you tell us about like what you thought of the whole thing?
Oh, I thought it was great. I thought it was really, really good. Really well choreographed. Shout out to Ms. Rockelman.
Yeah.
All the dance classes surprised me. Honestly, I thought it was just gonna be like Momentum was really good, and the dance classes were kind of just there, but. All the dances were honestly great, and I definitely saw the hold up big moment for him.
Well, I was going to ask you what's your opinion of how Jacob did.
Oh, I thought he did great. Stole the show.
So
thank
did
you.
I.
Thank you. Thank you.
Like, first I was surprised to see you up there.
No, man, I love to dance.
And like, then when I saw you there, I'm
like a dancing type of guy, actually.
Really. I'm like, he's got moves. I was surprised. I was like, this. I was like,
there's like a big debate. Like, I feel like, did you watch Chance?
I did watch.
Yeah,
Chance.
Me and Chance had like a really big argument because he's like so stiff. Like, he just danced so stiff. I'm like a loose type of guy. So like, I'm like better than him at dancing. So
yeah, I was. I saw you and like I saw you and like James Camacho.
Yeah.
We're kind of like on opposite sides at one point, and it was just like going back and forth looking at you guys.
But like, other than that, like Ms. B, like I give her props because she had to handle like all like the dance classes. Remember, because she came up with all those dances in each song, like the timing of it and all that. So I give her props.
Yeah, she's incredible. Every year they do it, and it just gets better and better. So congratulations for doing that. That's great stuff. I was at the Deca States. Over the weekend. And you know, I've never really seen anybody here ever been involved in anything with DECA.
Actually, no.
I gotta say that these kids, they work their tails off. I mean, what they were doing up there, like they were really doing real business proposals. That it was like everybody was on Shark Tank. Like that's what it felt like. Like they're trying to convince these strange people to buy whatever they're selling. And the passion in which they did it was just phenomenal. So, and you know, I got to give props to Miss Moore, who runs DECA. And I'm actually surprised.
How long was the trip?
We were there for 4 days, three nights and 4 days in Orlando at a hotel like the Hilton right by Disney Springs. Yeah. So we spent some time there. We went to Universal for a day. But it wasn't like the kids were using this as a chance to get away, get out of school for a couple of days. They went there to work. They went there to work. So I was impressed. I was there to chill. And chill I did because I didn't have much to do. Like basically I was there for like an emergency. You know, I was looking for things to do. I was like, let me judge something. Let me like critique something. But
were you the only one there?
No, it was myself, Miss Moore, and Miss Pepe were there. But it was really cool. So that's DECA States. I want to ask you guys because, you know, we're always trying to do things at the school. I want to ask you guys, how many times would you say in a week the average high school kid goes to the bathroom during the day, during classes? Like No. I mean leaving the room to, quote unquote, go to the bathroom.
I go once every period.
Once every period.
Okay.
Sometimes twice.
Last year, like,
yes.
Like,
yeah.
Sir, I just need like a break from like that. I just need a walk
right.
around.
Okay.
Just, like,
all right. All right.
I'm tired of hearing people talking.
Well,
that's true.
Imagine Tyler saying that.
I concur with Tyler.
So you would say about 4 times a day.
Well, once in each class.
Yeah.
I drink a lot of water.
And obviously, they're not always to go to the bathroom.
No.
Right.
Well, for me, it is. I drink so much water throughout the day.
Okay, that's
for me,
fair.
Usually, that's
fair. Because you know, we're trying to like find ways to not have that happen. And the first step is obviously not make you want to leave class. But you know, we're looking for ways to like sort of like, I don't know, sort of calm down the halls. Why are you laughing? Well, yeah, of course. I mean, I went to high school. We know how it works, but. You know, we're just trying to come up with strategies to sort of like, you know, like how many times do you actually have a pass with you?
Never.
It right. Depends on the class.
Only if I leave during shank.
It's like a board that he made on his own.
Oh, I always see that. It's so funny.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, it's if you have a system, it's good.
Yeah.
You know, it's tough for me. I'm a floater, so it's tough for me to have a subject
class,
to whatever the rooms are. But, all right, yeah, it's just interesting to see how many. So now that I've got you all on record, Groothuis is going to be coming after you. You will have – no, I'm just kidding. No, it's important for us to know so we can sort of figure out how to, like, alleviate some of the hallway traffic, you know, that's kind of frivolous.
I don't know what there really is to do. People probably won't listen anyways.
All right.
Oh my God,
well, hey, we got to make it seem like we're trying to do something anyway. But so what else is going on at the school that you guys are interested in?
I see athletic news next, but like, I just want to throw this in. So a lot of athletes, and this was requested to me from a lot of athletes from around the school to bring up. So the athletic cord is going out for graduation, and the requirements are you have to play a varsity sport junior and senior year. But my question is, I could name off the top of my head so many great athletes we have at the school that are, their sports are year round. So they don't have the opportunity to play two sports, junior and senior year. So I'm just like, it's kind of astonishing me that they won't have the opportunity to get represented at graduation with an athletic cord.
I hear you. So my first question would be, why, since there are no sports that are technically year-round, it's year-round because the program chooses that, right?
Well, yeah, but like, you, I mean, at, it's like, look, like, at baseball. Baseball, okay, has spring baseball and fall baseball. If you were to play, let's say, basketball or football in fall, but you wanted to play, but you were like a really good, strong baseball player, like that was your thing, like you only play baseball, well, you can't really play football because that might hurt you for spring. And the same thing, if you look at basketball, basketball is travel basketball, softball is soft, travel softball. Football, you train year-round, you lift year-round with the team. You know, it's just hard because, like, to me personally, like, seeing, like, all these great athletes that have provided so much to the athletic program this year and, like, their whole careers not get represented or acknowledged at graduation, it's kind of like let them down in a sense.
All right. Anybody else have any thoughts on that?
I agree with
totally
that.
I agree with him. I agree.
Yeah. You have a great receiver like Collin Teschky, not getting represented, I feel like.
Hey, look, he's not. The season's over. You don't have to kiss his butt anymore, all right? He's just Collin now. He's not.
I'm just Collin. I'm, well, just here.
All right. So I'm going to tell you a very brief story. When I was coaching JV basketball, okay, this goes probably about 7-8 years ago. All right. We had a couple kids on the team who were also football players. One of them you would definitely know. I'm not going to mention any names, but one of them you would definitely know, at least know of. All right? So they wanted to play basketball, all right? But, of course, they were being pulled over to lifts and all that stuff, so they were barely coming to practice. And they might show up at the game. And then when they would show up at the game and they didn't play because they were really good, I didn't play them as much as they would have because they didn't show up. And then finally, they just kind of, like, stopped coming. So I, for lack of a better word, I kicked them off the team because they weren't showing up. And I cut people that year. So they were taking people's spots. And then when they got cut, they came up to me and said, what's going on? I said, you're never there. Well, we have to go to football lifts. And I said, no, what you have to do is make choices. And so my response to you is the – We're supposed to encourage people to play more than one sport. So if a sport like football or baseball is going to require that off-season their players still be devoted to that sport, that's the choice that they make. That's the part I don't agree with. I think that coaches should be encouraging. Like, if you're playing football, okay, you're playing football in the fall, and you're not playing anything else during the year, then yes, you should be at lifts every day, or you should be doing what the. But if you are playing another sport like track or whatever's going on, that should and must be your number one priority athletic wise, with no repercussions. Because I know people were afraid, oh, well, I'll go back, I won't get the good equipment or whatever. Like, that's what was going on around that time. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but in that sense, like you said, how the coaches were pulling students, but why are we then punishing the students by not acknowledging?
No, I agree. I just said it's the coaches. Wait a second. Hold on, DJ. I know you got to go. Hold on. We're on athletics now. So DJ's got a volleyball game. He's going to talk briefly about the volleyball, but let me finish with this. So I do agree with you. It's not the kids' fault. The coaches need to understand, or at least there needs to be some kind of policy that says, you know, nobody requires you to play fall baseball. It's not even a real thing. Mm-hmm. It's like rec. It's basically the same thing as travel.
It's the same thing with spring football.
Yeah. So kids need to be able to do those things without worrying about losing their spot. And that is the I think that's the problem that you're talking about. It's the individual coaches need to understand that people are not just doing one thing at school. It's like it's like different clubs. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to expect that, you know, the people who are in clubs are usually not just in one club. They're usually in every club. So teachers are and advisors are going to have to realize that they're going to have to share you guys. I mean, that's just the way it works. But before we get back to that, DJ, you are playing volleyball, boys volleyball. What's your record so far?
Right now we're 2-0 regular season, and we went 1-1 in the preseason tournament.
That's great.
Yeah, it's
like
great.
That's
we're already on a much better track than we were last year. Last year we had phenomenal players. Brian Rubino was absolutely amazing.
Rubino
was an amazing player, but we didn't have as well-rounded of a team as we do this year. This year, our starters are all great. Most of us play club, and our bench players are also great. A lot of them are new, and they're developing fast. So it looks like it'll be a good season. We're about to go kick Glades, you know.
Ass?
Yeah.
I have a boy on that team.
I didn't know if I was allowed. But, yeah, it's looking like it's going to be a good season.
It's all right. Nobody's listening anyway. But so you're playing Glades.
Yeah.
Who else is on your team? Who else is on the team?
Oh, man. Audith? Probably not.
Audith.
Kawa.
Yeah. Wait, who? Hannah, what? Hannah, why are you pointing at Anna?
Hannah knows Audith. Hannah knows Audith.
No.
Oh, God. Wow. All right. Anyway, moving on.
Tajalli, are you listening?
All right. Thank you for your time, everyone.
Well, good luck, DJ. Have a great game. Thank you for joining us today. Have a great weekend. He's just running out the door. All right. It's been a pleasure. So Tyler, what do you have to say about or any of you? Do you have thoughts about what we were just talking about the
totally
multi-sport
agree.
Thing?
No, I agree with Collin on his point of it.
Yeah, I like everything Collin said. I mean, maybe they should change it to like if you play 4 years of a sport.
That's what I was thinking. 4 or 3 years.
Yeah.
I just think you kids have a lot of pressures on you coming from many different directions. And I guess if you are totally dedicated to a sport, like if that's what you are, if that's what you do, then I can see, okay, you have a relationship with the coach and the coach expects a certain level of leadership from you. But if you're on the team and you want to play other sports or you want to be in another club or do something, my opinion is we need to encourage that instead of discourage that by punishing kids for wanting to do other things. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but like what I'm saying is that like now, like the senior athletes, a lot of them who were great, played 4 years, some even played at middle school, they won't be recognized as an athlete at graduation. And I think that's what's upsetting them the most is that they were always seen as a student athlete, and in graduation they're just going to view them as a student.
Well, to be honest, I mean, they'd have to turn around and look at the program. Right? They'd have to be like, you didn't allow me to go do this. Mm-hmm. Am I wrong about that?
No, you're not wrong.
Is that what it is, though? Like, is that how it works?
I think it is, like, especially looking at softball and baseball, especially. Because football, like, you still have, like, time. But softball and baseball, like, you have travel. So even over the summer, they're playing.
But again, that's a choice.
Yeah.
Travel is a choice. It's got nothing to do with the school.
Yeah.
So if you're going to make your choice, like, again, when I coached middle school baseball last year, half my team wouldn't show up because they had travel practice. Yeah. It was very frustrating. So I can understand the coach's perspective as well. But when you coach, you are coaching a team as part of the school.
That's true, yeah.
So it's but that is a concern that I think needs to be addressed, because the last thing we want is kids walking out of here, you know, sort of looking back and being like, well, what if, you know? So I agree with you that it needs to be addressed. So that's a very good point. I'm glad somebody finally brought it up. So
I just think the best idea is to do 4 years.
Yeah.
Well, you play soccer, Hannah. So what? No. So well, you're wearing a soccer
okay,
shirt.
SATO, that's why.
What does that mean?
Student athletic trainer. It's
no, I understand what it is, girls. But so you get all the free gear from all the sports.
No, soccer, just soccer. Just soccer. I just got, like, the water.
You got the water and you get a shirt.
And I got a shirt, yes.
That's,
I got
you
two
know
shirts,
what?
Actually.
Now that is America. I love it. That's terrific. Yeah. Have you played any sports?
I played soccer, like, not seriously when I was younger. Like, okay. Rec, and I swam for a little bit. Never was a calling.
Okay. That's okay. But so tell us about SATO. What's like? I haven't seen. Honestly, I've sort of been out of the athletic part this year. I did bowling, but what's how is it being an athletic trainer? Has it changed?
Well, it was just I'm in HOSA, so that's how you do it, and you can like sign up for whatever sport you want, like boys, girls, and I did the girls' varsity team, and it was a lot of fun. It was like I bonded with all the soccer girls. Like,
yeah.
Obviously, Grassi, I have her as a teacher too. And I would just like fill up the water before the games. Like we'd all go on the bus, like get the balls. Like,
is it true that you trainers actually kind of root for someone to get hurt so you can like run on the field and like carry them off and look like heroes and everything?
We're not even allowed to.
It's a myth.
We're not allowed to go on the field unless Coach Thompson's there.
Right.
So and he'll.
Well, I would hope so.
Oh, yeah.
I would hope.
Well, like, so no one is really running on the field, and if they are...
It's like this kid's having cardiac arrest. Well, we have a high school junior here who's going to, like...
Plus, like, there's always, like, an actual athletic trainer there, so they're the one that's, like, taking care of them. But, like, by chance, like, if after the game, like, one of the girls, I actually did wrap a few ankles.
Hey!
I was pretty good at it.
For
or,
you.
Like, or, like, ice. I did that, too. It was ice and wrapping ankles. Yeah, and it was a good learning experience.
That's great. That's great. Is that anything having to do with like what you're interested in doing?
Yeah.
In the future.
I've always been like interested in medicine in general, like not specific to that, I guess.
Okay.
But
good.
Like HOSA is good for that.
Nice. Yeah. That's great, Jacob. I haven't really spoken to you. So like,
no, I haven't.
What you got anything going on after? Like, are you going to school?
No, yeah. What are you thinking of doing? Going to FAU.
Nice, yeah. My alma mater. Yeah. We're owls, baby.
Nah, it's like, I don't know. Since the beginning of the year.
Shut up, Colin. Like,
towards like the beginning of the year, I kind of wanted to go away, but like I kind of like did like a test of it. So I went with like a couple of my friends up to like UCF and all that, and like I don't know. I just like found it just like partying and all that there. Like yeah, like it's
yeah,
fun
that's
enough,
that's horrible.
But, like, I kind of like did all that already. I don't really find like a fun to it that much. So like, I just want to do school here, stay home. Make money, so and I.
Okay, so you stay here. Can I go to UCF? Because it sounds like a great.
Be my guest. But I mean, yeah, I mean, I'm gonna do that. I was gonna do start like a business major or like sports medicine. I'd say because like after high school, I'm gonna get like my personal trainer certification. So
really,
yeah, you remember Derek, right?
Chrysler?
Yeah,
of course.
Yeah, he got his, and he had a job at EOS.
Look at him.
Yeah, he was telling me about that.
So, oh, good for him.
And I just got into like I didn't just get into it, but like I turned 18 in January.
Congratulations.
So I started doing like day trading in stocks. So like I started like getting more into it, and I took like a 3-month course before, like because my uncle does that.
Right.
So
in other words, we're all going to be working for you in 2 years. I'm looking forward to it.
Speaking of UCF, I have two things to say. One, in athletic news, congratulations to Tyler Taraboulous on his first college football offer.
Yes. Yes. Attaboy.
No, it wasn't from UCF, but
yeah, it was from a weird school. What is that school?
It's all good. He has an offer.
He is an O. That's all that
Bluffton.
So somewhere in Ohio, I mean, like, reached out to me kind of out of nowhere.
Yeah, sounds like Joe's College and Ribs or something.
Congrats,
you know?
Congrats to you.
Random. I mean, I've never heard
who cares?
Until it's an
who
offer.
Cares? No. Literally, who cares? You know, if you, I mean, I know you'll get more, but. If that was the only one, you go there and you play ball, and you know.
But he also got into UCF. That's the thing.
Maybe.
Oh, you mean you got into UCF?
I did get into UCF.
And you could walk on.
I could try. Yeah, maybe in like a year or two.
So what are you thinking?
Undecided still.
Undecided. Hey,
leaning towards that.
Commitment post.
Hey, you're only a senior in high school in the fourth quarter. Yeah. Well, I hope that you do what you want to do. And not what you feel you have to do.
Thank you.
That's what I remember. Tyler, I coached Tyler, and when he was little league baseball player over at. So every time I see him, it just freaks me out because there was a period of time where we didn't think Tyler knew if he was a righty or a lefty.
What?
Like righty or batter?
I don't remember this.
But we had so much fun at North Springs. I mean, the thing was you were kind of afraid of the ball.
I remember that.
Like when you, I mean, this was when he was like 6 years old.
Okay.
So he was afraid of the ball. And after every, when every pitch would come in, he would back away. and they'd be perfect pitches. He was just afraid of it. And then the umpire would call him out on strikes, and he'd be like, what do you mean? I haven't swung the bat once. And he's like, that's the point. The ball's been right over the plate. I remember coaching it with his dad, Paul, and we just had so much fun. And so Tyler and I go way back. And it's just I love seeing Tyler, like, talking about playing football in school and playing football here. It's just great. Than getting me fired from my announcing job.
Going way back.
What?
Yeah.
Was it my fault? What?
No, it was not his fault. It was my fault, and I did it on purpose, and I do not take it back. I was calling. They didn't like us calling the guys by their nicknames. His nickname is Ice-T.
You got fired? And that's,
well, not fired, but they didn't want me doing it anymore because I was kind of being blatant about it. I was like, because he wasn't getting in as much as I wanted him to. So I was like, put iced tea in. I should have been a little more objective, but it's been an adventure. So moving on, Hannah was begging me not to ask her about this, but
hey, don't say that.
But we have to. No. Hannah is of course part of National Honor Society, and they're always up to some interesting things. So is there anything you could tell us about some things going on with NHS and Mr. Singer and what's up over
love
there?
Love Mr. Singer. Love that guy.
Me too.
We're just doing the basics, you know, tutoring, service institute, pickleball.
Pickleball, nice.
The Vice Sports is starting, so I might do that. Pickleball seems fun.
I think we need a pickleball team at Charter.
It's like
how many years are we away from
the coach
that?
Right in front of us, too.
What's that?
I think pickleball? We have the coach right in front of us.
Oh, jeez. Every time they ask me to coach a new thing, it always ends badly, all right?
Do you play?
No. Oh. I don't play anything.
You need Mr.
Griffith. I come here, and I go home and go to sleep. That's what I do.
Really good.
That's what I do. No, but pickleball is becoming like a big deal. Like, and
I don't think I've ever played pickleball in my life.
You would love it. You would actually really enjoy it.
Like, how do you play?
It doesn't look like much fun, but it's like basically ping pong, but you're standing on the table. That's basically what it is.
Four people, right? Isn't it like two in the
front? Right? Am I
what an analogy?
Am I wrong?
Maybe I'm not thinking of the right thing.
So what are you thinking of?
I thought it was like similar to like a baseball structure.
No, it's like table tennis. No, it's like table tennis.
Yeah, it's like tennis. No, it's like two people and then two people, right?
It's not to insult anybody, but it's really an old person's game that has. That has that has sort of drifted into like the youth culture.
Yeah.
So a lot of kids play it. So
my family plays.
So do you guys still do the Parkland Buddy sports?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Oh, you're playing pickleball with them?
Oh, yeah, that's what it
so
is.
So how do you like that? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, when I did it, I did running. It was actually really fun. The kids are really sweet, and it's just like, and they're really happy to see you, like. They love it. Like, they love their, like, because you get paired up, and then, like, every week you go, and it's, like, the same person. And
right.
So you just, like, really get to know the kid, and even their family. And it's just really sweet, because they're really happy, and they're having a lot of fun. And
they, like, idolize you.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you.
And it's, like, I was, like, nervous to do running. I was, like, I hate running. But then it was, like, little laps that I was, like, jogging. Like, it wasn't even, like, I'd sometimes be walking. So it was a lot of fun. I want to do pickleball, though.
Yeah. Are you running for an officer position next year?
No.
SGA.
Oh, she's being poached.
Can you release the position?
She got poached by SGA, Jacob.
Can you release the position?
What was that?
They're stealing her away from National
Honor
Society.
This is her campaign announcement right now. She's declaring.
I plan to go for vice president.
Ooh, okay.
My position.
But I got an opponent.
Who's the opponent?
Aiden Tarsus. I don't even know if he knows.
We need to have a.
Does he know that he's running?
He knows he's running, but I don't even know. No, because I think he thought I was running for something else, but I think he knows.
There's a lot of weight to the Tajalli name there.
I'm so nervous.
Well, about what?
Because what if he wins?
He's not going to win. We'll take care of that.
No, the meeting though.
We'll find some dirt. We'll take care of that. He's done. He's done. Tarsus, you're out. All right, Tajalli wins by default. All right, well, that's great going on NHS. Besides you two, meaning Collin and Tyler, you guys got any good spring break plans? I know what they're doing, but what are you guys doing?
Working.
Yeah.
And I'm going to like Miami. I have to like, I don't know. I'm supposed to like do like a partnership with like my uncle and stuff. So
Mm-hmm. By, like, doing what? Stuff.
He does like a clothing apparel, but like I'm trying to do like the finances of it. So, but I still have to like learn like the basics and stuff. So I have to go to like Miami, learn that. So.
Look at you. You're doing like all these different things. And that, yeah. I think that's really, that's great.
No, because like, in the beginning of the year, I was like very stressed out of like, because I was very like undecided what I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. So like now I feel like I have like a goal set, not like major goals, but little goals by like each month and stuff.
Jacob, so. I'm 47 years old. I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do. So don't worry. You're doing just fine. But no, that's good because you're experiencing a whole bunch of different things.
And I started like, I don't know, I started like talking to like a lot more people, like just getting yourself out there, getting to know a lot more things, like learning new things. So like, because like, mm-hmm. the basics of life is going to help you with that. So
well, that's terrific. I'm very happy to hear that. That's awesome.
Thank you.
What about you, Hannah?
Okay, well, I'm not really doing anything. I'm just staying home.
Doing nothing. How often in your life do you get a chance to actually just sit around and do nothing?
Not
this year. Definitely not you guys. No. You know. So I actually there have been like Christmas vacation. I hardly left the house.
I really being home for Christmas.
I really enjoyed just like.
I was getting too in that break. I was hanging out with my friends.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with like some people always feel like they need to. Oh, God, I don't even know. But there's, you know, everyone thinks like, oh, we got to get up and do stuff. We got to go. Sometimes it's just cool to just chill and just enjoy not having any responsibilities, at least for some time. So, yeah, so we got spring break coming up at the end of next week. Our two football guys are going to be headed to Italia. I'll be joining them. So that should be interesting. We'll see. Yeah, I'm going.
Oh, we're gonna have time of our life.
We'll see. We'll see if we make it back with all of our limbs intact.
No. If we do, we're not having fun.
That's a good point. Hopefully, Tyler won't be detained by Italian police.
We're gonna have an international crisis on our hands.
Is it just Italy?
Yeah, we're just going to like.
Tyler's like, whoa! Don't blow up my spot.
Yeah. Hey, if I was a woman's basketball. Trade for
oh, hey now, there you go, attaboy. So we always end this thing with a segment called "What Are We Watching?" All right, so like, what are we watching on TV, or did we see a movie or something you could share that you're watching this week or that you saw that might be of interest?
I mean,
so we'll
like,
go
just
around.
To, like, Jacob. Start, like, I just ended the. Well, I didn't like just end. I said a couple weeks ago, I finished Outer Banks.
Yeah,
like, that's like my favorite show. Like, that's like my go-to. I live for that show. Like, cause like I like, I'm into like all that stuff, like surfing and all that. I used to do all of that, but like I just like stopped because like I just stopped going. So like I don't know, it's my favorite one, but I just finished it. And but I mean, it was all right though, cause like I don't know, season one and two were like really good, but then like season three was like, eh. I'd say
that's what I've heard.
Season one's best.
Yeah.
What is that? What is that on? What platform?
Netflix.
Netflix.
I think it's more than Netflix, or is it just Netflix?
I think it's just Netflix. It's Netflix original.
Just Netflix.
All right,
but
so Jacob
like,
is
my go-to show right there. Yeah,
it's a really good show.
Like, and is it over?
What do you mean?
No, there's a
like. So it's on the third season.
Yeah, it's not, like they just like made the third one, but like they already like established there's like a fourth one coming.
Oh, okay, great.
Yeah.
All right, good. So Jacob is recommending the first two seasons of Outer Banks.
My God. Yeah.
Third one, the little step down.
I mean, it's like all of it's good, but like once you see like one and two, like that sets the bar.
Gotcha.
Like, yeah.
Okay. All right. Good. Hannah, what do you got?
I've been watching The Last of Us.
Oh, that was mine last week, yeah.
I love that show. It's actually because it's like, it's for the people watching. It's like based on a video game, and it's like basically about like a whole zombie apocalypse, and it's so good. It comes out every Sunday on HBO Max, and me and my mom watch it together, and it's really good.
So how many episodes have there been?
I think eight.
Yeah, so I'm still on the third. That's where I was last week.
I know.
Wait, I
haven't
that.
Well, I haven't.
It's so good.
It's not pulling me back in. Like no, I did like it, but it's not like, oh, I got to get home and watch this. I guess I got to get to the fourth episode.
I just have a routine of like 9 o'clock every Sunday. You and mom watch it, and it's so good. It's really, you have to watch it. Like there are some boring parts, but like overall,
it's not that it's boring. It just wasn't pulling me back. Mm-hmm. I was like, yeah, this is good. I like the Mandalorian guy. I like.
Yeah,
the
really
cast,
good.
I like the whole thing, but it wasn't like, oh, I got to get back and see. I can't wait till the next episode. I have not had that experience with this show, but I will go back in. That's HBO Max, correct? Okay.
You should watch it.
All right, Last of Us, another.
This weekend.
Sunday. It's a total of 9 episodes?
Yeah, and this all is right. The shortest episode. Like,
I'll download them. I'll watch them on the plane.
Yes, watch it.
Yeah, okay. I will. Take it easy.
Good. No, you need to.
All right, get your work in. I'll watch it. You get. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Kidding. Well, I didn't hear that. Tyler, what do you watch?
I heard that
Creed School of Hard Knocks.
I heard Creed 3 is coming out soon.
Creed 3 already came out.
Oh, it did come out?
I saw it.
I thought you said it was bad.
I didn't say it was bad. I said I didn't like it. That doesn't mean it's bad. I'd actually be interested to hear what you have to say about it, if you said.
I haven't seen it yet.
No, I mean, when you see it, yeah, I'd be interested to hear what you said.
Yeah.
I didn't like it that much, and I'm a huge Rocky fan, and that's part of the Rocky verse.
How many have you seen the first one?
All right, get out. all right, yeah. Well, I recommend it. I mean, for you to see it, I think you would like it. Me personally just didn't do it for me. So anybody else see it or no?
I have not.
Nobody like goes to the movies much anymore.
Yeah. I went last week.
It's been a long time. I missed Creed 2 actually.
Creed 2 was awesome.
So did I think.
That many good movies,
no.
I loved Creed 2. Loved
Creed 1 was like my favorite movie of all
time. I like Creed 2 even better than Creed 1.
Creed 1's just a Rocky copy though.
It is not.
I feel like it is.
I'm confused. All
right, it is a little bit, but but hey, they could that movie's so great they could copy it a million times and I'll be the first one in line.
Boxing,
yeah. So, all right, Collin, we know what you were looking forward to watching last week. It was like the night. I think we did it the day before
the release.
The release. So, what do you got for us?
I'm gonna say the same thing. Season 3 Mandalorian. So I watched the first episode, which came out last week. It comes out every Wednesday. I haven't watched the second episode yet. I plan on watching that tonight. Have you watched the second episode?
No.
Oh, you haven't?
Right. But I thought you were going to get upset with me for not watching the second episode.
No, I haven't watched it
now
yet.
Now I'm a little annoyed with you because you promised.
I'm a little busy. I've been a little busy.
That's true. You are.
So I'm going to plan on watching it tonight. But I wasn't a big fan of episode 1 because the only reason it was short, it was only half an hour. So the episodes are usually 45 minutes to an hour. So it was only 30 minutes. And like, I get the reasoning. It was like a setup episode for all the adventures he's going to go on throughout the season, all the battles he's going to have. But, like, come on.
So
like,
basically,
it's the Mandalorian. We know what he's going to do.
So it was basically like a 30-minute trailer, is what you're saying?
In the sense, yeah.
Okay, and you haven't seen the second
one? I have not seen the second one yet.
Well, it's Friday. You got some time? Oh, no, you got to play dodgeball.
I do. Are you going to be there?
Yeah.
You're going to be there coaching us up?
No, I'll explain why when we're done.
Okay.
No, I was going to play on the team, but you guys didn't need it. I was the last man standing. I did not back down, right? For the record, I was on the dodgeball team, the teacher team. I said yes, I was in, and then Collin said everybody else backed out, and we don't need the team anymore. So I'm like, well, I won't tell you what I called them, but anyway. So I am watching something on Hulu. There's a guy named Hulu, right? I didn't know this thing existed, but it's called Hulu.
Great service. Has everything.
Great service. It's called History of the World Part 2. Have any of you ever heard of History of the World Part 1?
Just History of the World?
All right. So to make this very, very short, okay, in the early 80s, I think maybe 1980, a comedy guy named Mel Brooks. Do you know who Mel Brooks is?
I've heard of the name.
Mel Brooks is like probably the biggest comedy legend alive right now. He's 96 years old, but he made like the greatest comedies of all time. Blazing Saddles, Young Frankenstein. If you look at any list of the funniest movies ever made, he will have 3 or 4 of them in the top 5. So he made a movie called History of the World Part 1, which was basically a very raunchy and R-rated kind of sketch movie about parodying different periods of history. So they started with the Stone Age, then they went to like the French Revolution, and they had all of these other ones, and it's hilarious. It's an absolute riot, especially if you like history and seeing the different twists. One sample joke: have you ever heard the Ten Commandments joke? Like literally, they have this. It's like a 1-minute sketch where Mel Brooks is playing Moses, and he's walking down the mountain to talk to God, and he's carrying the tablets with the commandments, right? You know your religion, right? The commandments. So he's got these 3 tablets, all right? And he's God is saying, Moses, come down and blah, 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 blah. And he's like, I am here. I hear you. And I give you these 15. And then he drops one of the tablets and it breaks. And he's like, hey, 10 commandments, 10. And that became like the famous joke from the whole thing, like how the 10 commandments became the 10 commandments. So here we are 40 years later, and they decide to do a History of the World Part 2 on Hulu as a TV series. And so far, it's funny. Not quite as funny as the other one, because the other one was very, like, Mel Brooks was known for very racy humor. Like, racy meaning, like, raunchy and, like, somewhat offensive, but offended everybody. Everybody. And you just can't do that these days. So it's kind of limited, but I have been laughing. A huge cast. It's got, like, Jack Black.
Oh, wow.
Johnny Knoxville. It's got, like, Seth Rogen is in it. Like, Seth Rogen. Like, yeah, it's got all these people who are just doing these small parts. Like, they did, like, the Civil War. Like, they played, like, Abraham Lincoln, who was just, they played him like a bumbling idiot, just, like, bumping into things and just, you know, being a complete stumble bum. It's just, it's funny stuff, and I'm enjoying it. And, you know, I like my mindless comedy every now and then. So, yeah, History of the World Part 2. And it's a play on the old joke, because the first movie was called History of the World Part 1 with no intention of making a Part 2. That was the joke. It was just they called it Part 1. So that's what I'm watching. So anyway, so anybody have any last things to say before we break for the weekend? And no, we're going to try to do another one next week. We're going to try to squeeze in one more before we skip town. So I hope to, because I'm really enjoying doing this with you guys. So any parting thoughts for the weekend? Any weekend advice, Jacob?
Don't be dumb. Just be smart. That's what you do.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Hannah, anything to anybody you'd like to shout out or anything?
Can I shout someone out?
Please.
Yeah. I have to shout out all my boy CZ Chris 101.
Should I even ask who he's talking about? Do I know who you're talking about?
You might know of him, yeah.
So?
I was talking about, I had like a podcast after school because he usually parks next to me at BC. He's
okay.
He's coming to walk with me. I'm like, nah, man, I got a podcast. He's like, all right, shout me out. I was like, I got you.
He doesn't go to this school?
No, he goes to this school.
So who is it?
Christian Salazar.
Of course I know Christian. Yeah. That's awesome, man. Yeah. Anybody else? Anybody want to give any?
My brothers are coming home this weekend.
Oh.
I don't know if Aiden will listen to this. I'll tell
Aiden will listen to this. Aiden actually was going to try to call in and kind of surprise you.
Oh, my God.
Because I think he's driving home right now. I think he's on his. I think he's on his home. I think he's on his way home right now.
Yeah,
probably.
But no, he did this with us last year. So
I know. I actually went back and listened.
And actually, Ian did one too.
Really?
We did one with Ian. I think one of the first ones. Yeah, wow. I think it was during COVID. We did it via Zoom, if I'm remembering. Yeah, we did it via Zoom, if I remember correctly. So
always
love to shout out the Tajalli boys.
Everywhere.
What about you, Tyler? Anybody? Anybody you want to say hi to? Uncle Paul?
Shout out Zachary Minoli.
Zach Minoli.
He really wanted to be on this one. He'll be on next week.
Yeah, I would love. Why didn't he come in? Where's he getting another tattoo?
I don't even know what he's doing. I think he has work, actually.
He wasn't invited.
Well, I'll invite him. All right. Shout out to Zach Minoli. And how about you, Colin?
I'll match Chris. I'll chat out BDAT 101.
And who is that?
That's Brandon Arthur Dettilly. You know,
hey!
He's been having a really grind of a week, you know, pushing the grades up, late work deadline, so had to shout him out. Came to school, grinded, got the grades up, so big shout out.
Well, that's great. I will shout out a student of mine, Caitlin Zilka, who just did an absolutely phenomenal presentation, global perspective. So I was really, really pleasantly, I won't say surprised. I'm always surprised when someone comes up with a really great one, because it is kind of complicated. But she did it today and she did a great job, and I just wanted to shout her out.
Awesome.
So, Caitlin Zilka, great work. So, all right, guys. Well, I do appreciate you joining us this week. Always a pleasure with you guys, and I wish you all a very happy and healthy weekend. And let's do this again next week. You know, we're right here. Here at the Panther Pod.
Oh, yeah.
In good old room 221.
Thank you, Dr.
Home
Carl.
Of the good Dr. Carl. We'll be seeing you next week live from Coral Springs Charter, the Panther Pod. This is Collin, Tyler, Hannah, Jacob, and what should I call myself? I can't call
the
myself.
Big G. Ooh,
yeah, you do it. You do it. Yeah. Yes, this is us saying fare thee well. Have a great weekend. We'll see you next time. Thank you.